Yo guys, this is Reinhardt, this is your favorite Russian talking, and this is gonna be Grr Mondays that's been released on Wednesday. And I wanna apologize for that, but I had a business trip that I had to take on Monday and Tuesday, hence why the video and streaming schedule got messed up. To compromise for that, I actually took a vacation for Thursday, Friday and Saturday, so expect a lot more streaming and more videos during those days that I usually work. So, nevertheless, we're gonna talk about the Rogue class. And I wanna talk from a perspective of developers messing it up every single time they release something. Every time the new MMO release, for some odd reason, the Rogue class should be overpowered. And that's just absolutely, like, ridiculous. Like, if I think about it this way, and if you guys think about it, Rogue by itself is actually a very, very hard class to balance because the stealth has a three different mechanics built into it. A, it's defensive cooldown, so nobody targets them. B, it also, because of out of the stealth, a lot of developers put either CC onto it, or like when they get out of stealth, they either CC somebody or they do a lot of bursts. And the third one is obviously the stealth. It usually gives the rogues an unfair advantage over opener because they have to open up out of stealth and they have an element of surprise. Nevertheless, also because of the rogues and they wear the leather armor, they should be an assassin class. Well, what happens is most of the time the assassin class also have a lot of defensives stacked onto it because a lot of developers think that the rogues usually stalls defensively, not defensively from... I don't know why the reason is. So, we're gonna talk about a few lists of MMOs where the rogues were actually pretty overpowered. And I wanna know your opinions here as well. Now, needless to say, I don't wanna say that I'm absolutely a rogue hater, which I am, and I don't wanna say that the rogues should be absolutely shit. I think they should be viable. But the problem becomes with the rogue classes and a lot of MMOs is that they start up very, very strong, then they get nerfed to the ground, and then they just waddle like a below average performance, which makes it not enjoyable for the first half of the people that actually play the damn game, play the expansion, quit the damn fucking game because of those reasons, and then when they actually finally nerf them to kind of please the crowds, rogues get absolutely discouraged of playing their class because it got nerfed so much that it's underperforming, and then they quit the game, thus creating kind of a vicious cycle. Which is bad, because developers should from the get-go making the rogue balanced class. But nevertheless, let's actually talk about a few scenarios where developers fucked up with the rogue creation class. First of all, I'm gonna start with the Rift. Rift is absolutely, they fucked it up badly. The rogue there would actually open up on you, put a bunch of poisons on you, then cloak of shadows, vanish, or just vanish, go to back to invisibility, and then reopen it again when the target is down to 20% HP. Makes sense, right? So, in the beginning, assassins were extremely, extremely powerful. Every time they would open up on somebody, it would usually one-shot them. Well, but once they opened up, they also have a stealth that can cover their asses. But once the stealth, which was on a relatively long cooldown, is down, then obviously, they were already a prey for everybody else. So, I guess it was not that big of a deal, but it still was the largest. One of the most frustrating cases with the rogues I had was Guild Wars 2. And it's, I actually made the fucking video about it. For some reason, developers thought it's a good idea. And I know they nerfed it, but nevertheless, it still happened. They thought it's a good idea to add a lot of elements and mechanics into one skill on a rogue skill bar. So I'm gonna start with the first one, which was a Heartseeker that got nerfed. But the Heartseeker was essentially a gap closer. It was kind of a leap, but the leap slash charge. On top of it, it was doing a decent damage when the target is below like 66% HP. But when the target is down to 33% HP, it was also acting as an execute. So basically, as a rogue in Guild Wars 2 or as a thief class, what I did is I actually created the smallest rogue possible. I popped a bunch of cooldowns and then I basically just went out there and did a bunch of Heartseeker leaps. And I was literally able to kill two or three people at the same time by using just pressing one button. On top of it, they also gave them ability called Pistol Whip. When you enrage your rogue or give them like a fury, just a fast attack speed, Pistol Whip essentially what it did is it would stun for 1 second the target and then it would channel kind of like a mini damage ability that would actually chunk up to 40% of somebody else's HP. But because the target was stunned, it couldn't literally do anything. So I would literally do a 2 to 3 pistol swaps or pistol wipes or whatever it's called, pistol shits on the target and it would die. So that's, they kind of fucked up. Also, another one of those furious moments we actually experienced in Warlords of Draenor when the Kanban droids first came out in the first season. Oh my god, dear baby Jesus. So we have 8-second kidney on top of the shadow that stands for another 4 seconds on top of the killing spree that was also 100% unpillable. Yeah, that would be bad, okay? And honestly, I don't blame developers as much because yes, they do fuck it up with the class because it is hard to balance. Rogues are legitimately a very, very hard class to balance. But nevertheless, the rogue theme has always to be present. And it always have to be, hey, if he is a very big damage dealer, he has to be squishy as shit. If he is very, very tanky, he shouldn't be doing a lot of damage. But the reason why I'm ranting right now is because the game that I'm playing a lot, which is Skyforge, guess what developers did with their rogue? They also fucked it up badly. Well, they give them ability. It's called Blood Harvest. Blood Harvest is a dot that you put on the target. That dot can chunk up to 60 to 70% of your HP. It requires half of their energy, but they regenerate energy back. They can only have Blood Harvest on one target, but that dot would do shit tons of damage. So they would hide behind the pillars, act like the biggest vagina in the world, and at the same time just put off Blood Harvest and fucking grind somebody else to death. Now, needless to say, all of those players are complete garbage and shit, and I usually shit on them, no problem at all whatsoever, except there are a few very, very good ones, and then that becomes a problem when they actually can foresee what you're trying to do to them. On top of it, in Skyforge, Rogue has one of the most defensives in the game, between one stealth that gives them damage immunity as well. For some reason, if you have dots on yourself and your stealth, you should actually be taking damage. Then they have a 10 second invulnerability shield, kind of a bubble from Paladin. Then they can get a Paladin symbol, which is another 4 second invulnerability. And then when they get down to 1 HP, they actually activate auto stealth again. Again, they're immune to all the damage possible. And usually if you pre-doubted them during that time on my Necromancer, I usually kill them. But if they pop a health potion in the stealth, and you can health spot in arenas as well, guess what, they don't die and they go back at it again, and it's extremely excruciatingly painful. Now, needless to say, Blood Harvest is gonna be nerfed next patch. I was expecting it to be nerfed this patch, but it will be nerfed next patch, and there you can deal with them, but it's very, very infuriating to deal with them. And yes, it will be nerfed, but guess what, again, then the rogue's gonna follow the theme where they're gonna be absolutely garbage and trash in PvP, or not as good or subpar. Like I said, there's a lot of games where the developers fucked up with the rogue creation class, making them too strong at the beginning, and then basically kind of a nerfing them to the point where they become below average. And that ruins the experience for both the player who plays the rogue and the players who actually play against the rogue, because usually rogues make people rage quit the games, and then developers see that they kind of make people rage quit the games, and then they nerf the rogues, and then the rogues kind of rage quit the games because they're not as powerful anymore. Whew. So that's my partake on the rogues. Tell me from your experiences, says when and where do you think developers fucked up with the rogue classes? And bring me the examples down below, and I will read your comments, I promise. Thank you for watching, my friends, and до свидания.